ChatGPT plugins is a game-changing development that signifies a new era in the field of artificial intelligence. By letting users build on its technology, OpenAI is turning into a platform. And as Bill Gates once put it, a platform is when the economic value of everybody that uses it exceeds the value of the company that creates it. That's a platform. This means that the total value of products made by developers like us using OpenAI technology may eventually be greater than the OpenAI itself. But what makes ChatGPT plugin special is that ChatGPT can actually write most of the code for its own plugin, allowing you to quickly prototype your ideas even if you don't know how to code. So in this video, I'll show you how to build a custom ChatGPT plugin using ChatGPT itself so you can make the most of this unique opportunity and be prepared when this feature is finally released. Let's get started. In this tutorial, we'll create a plugin for one of my favorite podcasts called Huberman Lab. This plugin will allow us to chat with Andrew Huberman himself and ask any health-related questions covered in his podcast episodes. But first, let's understand how ChatGPT plugins function and the general guidelines provided by OpenAI. Primarily, each plugin should have a JSON manifest file containing basic details such as plugin's name, image, and descriptions. Interestingly, there are two descriptions, one for humans and one for AI. The AI description, along with your API specification, helps the model determine when to use your plugin. I often refer to these models as tools in my videos. But can they truly be considered tools if they can use their own tools? Share your thoughts in the comments. Now, let's dive into the tutorial. The specifics of creating and uploading embeddings fall outside of the scope of this tutorial. If you're unfamiliar with Pinecone and want to create a plugin similar to this one, check out my previous video and return to this tutorial later. Once we have uploaded our data to Pinecone, it's time to start building. Here's how to generate most of the code for your ChatGPT plugin using ChatGPT itself. First, define the main endpoints that your app will use with Fast API. In this example, we'll need only one endpoint, so begin the prompt with write an app using Fast API that has a query endpoint. Add the following sentence. Include a main section that will run this app using UVCorn on host 0000 port 8080. Next, instruct ChatGPT to include additional endpoints from the OpenAI documentation by saying, in addition to the normal endpoints, include a route well-known AIPlugin.json that serves the content of AIPlugin.json located in the same directory. Exclude this route from the OpenAI API spec. Add middleware by saying, include middleware and allow all methods from chatopenai.com. Finally, if you plan to host an image for your plugin, say serve image located in the same folder. After generating your code, be sure to ask for a requirements.txt file. By following these steps, you should already have about 90% of the code needed to create your ChatGPT plugin. Depending on your use case, you might even be able to generate all of it. However, some newer libraries and SDKs like Pinecone Client may appear outdated. As a result, we'll write this part of the code ourselves. First, copy the generated outputs to your project folder and add a few more requirements for querying embeddings. Next, import the necessary libraries, set the API keys, and connect to your Pinecone index. Now, implement the query function logic as follows. Get the text from the query and create an embedding for this text. Compare this embedding to all other embeddings in a database using Pinecone's query method. Store the results for the response in a dictionary until they exceed a certain token limit and return them. With the main logic of our plugin complete, copy the AI plugin JSON file from the OpenAI documentation and write the descriptions. In my case, I instruct the tool to answer health-related questions based on Andrew Huberman's podcast episodes. To test your app, change the API URL in the AI plugin JSON file to localhost 8080. Install your packages and run it with the command python main.py. Then click develop your own plugin in the ChatGPT interface and enter the same address. Now you can already use your plugin and interact with it live. However, in this tutorial, we'll take it a step farther and deploy it on Google Cloud. This way, you will be able to use your plugin anytime without having to run any commands on your local PC. We'll be using ChatGPT for deployment as well. But first, let's set up a Google Cloud account. Visit the Google Cloud website and complete the registration process to activate a free trial. You will receive $300 in free credits for 90 days, which is more than sufficient for our needs. Then create a new project, select it and take a note of your project ID. Once you've completed these steps, return to your previous conversation with ChatGPT and ask, how do I deploy and run this app on Google Cloud Run? Follow ChatGPT's suggested steps until your app is live. If you encounter any issues, remember that you can provide the error message to ChatGPT for quick assistance. Additionally, I will be able to answer any questions in the comments. If your code requires environment variables, ask ChatGPT how to set them on your system before deployment as well. The code for my plugin will be available in the description. After you have successfully deployed your app, there is just one more task that we need to do. Locate and copy your server's URL from the terminal after deployment is complete. Replace the localhost URL in the aiplugin.json file with your server's URL. Ensure that the API URL ends with /openapi.json and the logo URL ends with /image. Rerun the last two commands starting with gcloud build submit and gcloud run deploy. Once the app is redeployed, return to ChatGPT, click develop your own plugin and paste the URL. Click install and your plugin should now be live. You can share this URL with up to 15 people while your plugin is not verified. Now it's time to test our plugin. As someone who practices intermittent fasting, I'm curious to know if fasting is beneficial for me. Occasionally, the model may not recognize that it needs to use your plugin. In these situations, you can either refine your descriptions or explicitly instruct it to use your plugin. For example, I can simply say ask Huberman and my plugin will be activated. Then the model will display interpretation of the results. From the outcome, it's clear that the information is sourced from episode 41, which covers the impacts of fasting and time-restricted eating. This confirms that our plugin is working as expected. Now, let's explore ways to enhance my productivity. In episode 57, Dr. Huberman highlights various studies to emphasize the health benefits of sit-stand desks, such as burning additional calories, improving posture, and alleviating neck pain. Lastly, let's examine the significance of sleep for overall health. Sleep appears to improve energy, focus, and promote a positive mood. That's it for this video. Let me know if you have any questions in the comments. And if you want to know more about how to leverage the power of AI, don't forget to subscribe.